Mr. President, at the outset, I would like to congratulate you, Mr. Tijani Muhammad Bande, on your election as President of the 74th session of the United Nations General Assembly. I pledge our full support to your presidency, and I'm confident that with your extensive experience, you will be able to lead the deliberation of this UNGA session to a great success. Let me also commend your predecessor, Madame Maria Fernanda Garces, for her successful presidency of the 73rd session of UNGA. Mr. President, the international community is facing myriad challenges. Many parts of the world have been experiencing more frequent and severe impact of climate change, which has extensively affected the livelihood of the people globally. Heat wave has swept across Europe, while drought has prolonged in many parts of the world. But in others, flood has been extensive, inundated residential and productive lands. In this context, while developed countries may have been more resilient too and able to adapt to the impact of climate change, developing countries, and in particular the least developed ones, are the most vulnerable, including in particular my own country. During the past 2 months, we experienced unexpected heavy rainfall as a result of tropical storm Pudo across the country, which has made nearly all provinces inundated, causing enormous damages to infrastructure, agriculture, and livelihood of the people. This has already costed millions of dollars to rehabilitate and restore the normalcy in the affected areas. Realizing the importance of combating climate change, the Lao government is focusing on the implementation of Paris Agreement. It is already mainstream its nationally determined contribution and integrating climate change and natural disaster risk reduction into the current National Social Economic Development Plan. In addition, our National Assembly has endorsed the law on disaster management, and it is expected to promulgate it soon. Currently, we are formulating national strategy on action plan on disaster preparedness and risk reduction. At the regional level, ASEAN also exerted common effort to address the impact of climate change and disaster risk management, among others. In this connection, we highly appreciate the United Nations support to ASEAN through the implementations of ASEAN-UN Joint Strategic Plan of Action on Disaster Management 2016-2020 and the Environmental and Climate Change Action 2016-2020. Having all these legal frameworks in place is not enough to combat climate change. Full and effective implementation of this instrument is the key. Yet, it would require joint effort at both national and international level to ensure such full and effective implementation. In this regard, as we commit ourselves at the national level, we would like to call upon the developed countries and all development partners to honor the commitment in contributing $100 billion per year to support the developing countries' mitigation and adaptation needs. Mr. President, peace and security is another important pillar that the international community must consolidate. We are fully aware that without peace, development cannot take root. Human rights cannot be upheld. This is the core objective and a solid foundation of the United Nations when it was founded. Since its inception, the United Nations has made significant achievement in many fronts, making significant contribution to the maintenance and promotion of global peace and security. This has created conducive environment for countries and regions around the world to make socio-economic development progress thereby lifting millions of people out of poverty. In this respect, multilateralism and enhancement of regional and international cooperation remain significant relevant. Therefore, the reform of the United Nations and other international organizations, including the international financial institutions, should be carried out in an inclusive, open, transparent, predictable, and democratic manner, with a view to addressing regional and global inequality and challenges. Otherwise, our journey to eradicate poverty and narrowing development gap within and among countries will remain an uphill task. Against this backdrop, we welcome the operationalization of the repositioning of the United Nations Development System so it can respond effectively to addressing the development needs and priority of member states, in particular attention to countries in special situation, namely LLC and SEED, so they can deal with pressing vulnerability and external shocks. The Lao PDR also continue to support the effort of international community to achieve disarmament and non-proliferation. Therefore, the Lao government has ratified the Treaty on Prohibition of Nuclear Weapons. Furthermore, we welcome the commemoration of the International Day of the Total Elimination of Nuclear Weapons held 2 days ago here in the UN. In the past few years, coupled with existing challenges such as conflict, terrorism, poverty, pandemics, climate change, disaster, and trade friction, we have seen increasing confrontation and tension. This has threatened international peace and security and eroded development gains. Therefore, we call for a strong political will and general commitment to strengthen multilateralism by adhering to the United Nations Charter and principle of international law, in particular, the principle of sovereign equality of states, independence, territorial integrity, non-interference in internal affairs. We believe that this is the best and only pathway to respond to and overcome the existing emerging challenges. Yet in spite of countless efforts of international community to resolve the conflicts in different regions of the world, the existing ones remain. In our region, ASEAN has enjoyed long-lasting peace, security, stability, which has served a favorable condition for national socio-economic development of all member states. We in ASEAN continue to promote regionalism and multilateralism that emphasize the importance of inclusivity, mutual benefit, and respect, which form solid foundation in all essential frameworks of cooperation within ASEAN. On the issue of Palestine, the Lao PDR reiterates its hope that the long overdue Israel-Palestinian conflict should be resolved by peaceful means in accordance with the relevant United Nations Security Council resolutions. The application of unilateral measures with extraterritorial implication is not only contrary to the principle of the Charter of the United Nations and international law, but it also hampers the national development of other countries. In this regard, my delegation once again calls on the lifting of the embargo on the Republic of Cuba so these sovereign countries and its people can enjoy freedom to participate in economic and trade relations with other countries in accordance with international law. Mr. President, the Lao government attaches great importance and is highly committed to the implementation of Agenda 2030 with an objective to develop economy and narrow development gap in the country. Despite various policy measures being undertaken, the progress remains slow as a result of capacity limitation and funding constraint, and development gap persists, especially between urban and remote rural areas. In this regard, regional and sub-regional development plans tailored to react to actual needs of people at the provincial and district levels are needed in order to deliver basic social services to the local population, especially in education, healthcare, income opportunity, enhancing market access for agricultural produce, and improving livelihood of the rural people. To finance the said national development plans and strategies, we have mobilized resources required from all sources available, undertaking initiative to promote domestic investment and attract high quality FDI, tax reform, diversifying economy, and promote public-private partnership in order to finance our national development agenda. In conclusion, Mr. President, we firmly believe that in addition to national ownership and leadership, the scale-up of global partnership is needed to accelerate progress towards the effective implementation of development agenda, such as 2030 Agenda, Addis Ababa Action Agenda, Paris Agreement on Climate Change, POA for groups of countries in special situation, with an ultimate objective of transforming our world into a healthy planet so all mankind can live in peace and prosperity. On this note, I would like to take this opportunity to commend the successful deliberations of the first high-level SDG summit and other high-level events organized at the margin of the UNGA this year, which would provide strong recommendation and inputs for the realizations of common ambitious sustainable development agenda and its lofty goals. The Lao PDA stand ready to work closely with all member states and other stakeholders towards a secure and prosperous world so that the present and future generation can live in peace, harmony, and development. Mr. President, before I end my remark, allow me to seize this opportunity to announce that the Lao PDR has decided to present its candidature for the membership of the United Nations Economic and Social Culture, or ECOSOC, for the term 2023-2025. This is the first ever that the Lao PDR has, which belong to the vulnerable group of LDCs and LDCs, to seek a membership in this important UN body. The Lao government would highly appreciate the valuable support from all member states for its candidatures. I thank you, Mr. President.
I thank His Excellency the Minister for Foreign Affairs of the Lao People's Democratic Republic.